2019 would have been my parents' 79th wedding anniversary today. So married on 10th of 10th, 1940. And I'm leaving this house now, going down to the function at the town hall. We're having a singer singing James Taylor and Carole King songs. It's me, ready to go. Well, that's the town hall up there, and already buses are coming, all the outlying towns, for this concert. Warracknabeal Town Hall. And they're all coming in. There you are. The Carole King show is in.
Thank you. everybody stay in one place anymore. It would be so fine to see your face at my door. And it doesn't help to know you're just time away. Long ago,
he was off the alcohol and off the drugs, and he asked her to be in his band to play keyboards, and he had recorded a song that she'd written for the Drifters, and he said to the audience, "Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to get the writer of this song up to sing with me." Now, I'll do a demonstration. You can be Carole King, right? So this is what happened. So Carole's behind there. That's nice. Yes, I'm sure she's sat right back behind the keyboards. So he said, "Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to get the writer of this song, Miss Carole King, up to the front of the stage with me to sing it." She had no idea, and she goes, she was in shock, because she was so scared of audiences, and she didn't know what to say to them, and she didn't believe in her voice. She didn't think she was a good enough singer. But he's literally dragged her out the front, and they sang this next song together. Then after that, she joined him on a tour with her own band, and the first night that she was on the road with him, in the middle of a song, the loudspeaker is switched on and a voice comes on saying, "Excuse me, Carole, I have to ask if you and the audience members could please leave the auditorium in an orderly fashion. It's probably nothing, but we've just had a report, there's a bomb in here." And she said, "Well, as long as it's not me that's bombing on stage." And they all laughed, and she realised, hey, this isn't so bad being out the front. I reckon I can entertain these people. They love my songs. I just have to be myself. And that's what she did, and she became the performer. Carole King, the performer, as well as everything else. Rest is history. This is the song they did together.
When this old world starts to get me down, our people are just too much. Out into space, up on the roof, it's peaceful as can be. And that the world below won't bother me. Stay wait.
Somewhere you go. Where the air is fresh and sweet, yeah. I care for you from the hustle and crowd and all that rat race noise out in the street. On my roof, up on the roof, up on the roof, yeah, oh yeah.
And like the stars, put on a show for free.
Far too
far on the roof.
up on the roof.
Now it's
by, to be loved by.
On behalf of you girls, I'll sing this song to all these wonderful men that make us ladies feel so special and loved, needed, wanted, so wanted. Yeah, I'm a lot of crap. Sing along. Here we went to Jimboola, We've had a lovely time. We're going home after this, back to Melbourne. And hope you enjoyed our little bit for the Seniors Week. Take care. Hopefully we can come back another time and see you again. Sing along with us.
When you're down and troubled and you need some love and care, and nothing, oh, nothing is going right, close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there.
Well, what a great concert. Just got a few acknowledgements to make.
The end of the show, Warracknabeal Town Hall. Now going down to a lunch. At the barbecue lunch at the shower offices. And this is Scott Street, Warracknabeal. Power drive, apparently. Interesting. The other end of Warracknabeal, Scott Street. The Palace Hotel will be opening by Christmas. The post office. More of Scott Street. And Federation Place and the Food Works, which is our reopened Food Works. There's another RGO down there as well. So here we are at the Royal Mail Hotel. So, Del Monte used to be. Oh, like a seat. It's quite a bit in Warracknabeal. Well, just heading up here, Doomboola Street to where those flags are. That's the coming up to where the show is on, agricultural show for Warracknabeal, and that thing is spinning around with probably lots of children and things on it. Anyway, let's go in and have a look. Where the railway line goes across. I measured this the other day. It is 4 foot 8.5 inches. That's a standard gauge line. Has been for 25 years or so, apparently. That's the train station up there. And just near where the houses are. And I obviously go that way, and this is back the other way on the line. And that is the show. Let's go and have a look. Sort of heading back to the house, and I found a little park here out of nowhere that I didn't know about. Tarrant Park. Interesting. Oh, what a fence. So I'm heading up to the station up there and back around to the fair. Here's the station. This looks like it probably still works. There's a bit of change down there for the things to go through. There's the station. It'll be done up. No grass to sweep up, but most of it's been swept up as of already. Show October 10, 2019, and here we go. Yes, well, things are happening here, and I might get a cup of tea here.
The tip over didn't happen.
Well, we've got the grand parade coming through.
Okay, open handicap throwing for Sean Peters. It's his third and final attempt at this hope. We certainly wish him well with it. Up he goes. No, just pass. Put your hands together for John. I think that might be a day crew. Well done. Also take this opportunity, ladies and gentlemen, for thanking John Peters very much for his kind support and sponsorship towards Six, I think. He's been a great competitor for a long, long time, and great to see him. Hit the bar and unfortunately the game didn't go over. Very close.
Big farm machine.
underneath there for Kane. Now put your hands together for Kane Dempsey, ladies and gentlemen.
The racetrack when they have races as well. So this is the showground, not the race course. The race course is over there. There's another one, and there's the building near my house. Tall building there. There's walking distance, which is great. Lovely weather. Now I've come up around a bit further on the showground, and we've got something with hay bales. And over here we've got the race course. Looks like a race course, doesn't it? A bit further around. Let's go and have a look at this course here. So it's where the start and end things are. That's where the end is. So the freshman rooms must be down there. Anyway, we'll have a little wander around. I can't see it there really anywhere else. Up here. That's the entry from up there off the highway. There's some cars going across there, some coming in. And then they come all the way down here to the race course, which is here. So we'll just go in as far as we can. The 31st, well, I think that's gone past now. It was, that was the day. And somebody, an accident or something. It's a race towel. Be some sort of refugees or something coming. Let's have a look here. From the public bar. All closed up, of course, at the moment. Like a lovely place to come for an afternoon of races. And I shall. And stalls for the horses. Lots of stalls for the horses. Very close. It's a race course. The race course and the showgrounds are all on Crown land. So they'll be here forever. Forever. Towers up near my house, two of them up there. Wander back. Well, that's me at Warracknabeal Racecourse. Look at the a soft hole somewhere. Here we are. Showgrounds again. Showbag warehouse. See what's over there. There we are. I'm just going out to do a bit of film in the afternoon light. The title's Robert Menchie's Care to His Book. With a little bit more openness on the camera. I hope the rest has been open. We're heading up to that line of trees up there, which is around the lake, well, around the Yarriambiack Creek. A local park up there. Gemino Street, another French type name. Southern buildings or something, still. That's where they've come from down that way. And we're heading still up this way. And there is the light bulb bridge we're going across in a few minutes. Bowls Club, closed to this. It's the bowls club. Some people are out bowling. This is the old croquet club. It's a car park now. Let's put the bowls go. Yarriambiack Creek. Seems to be flowing north. It does. I think it does. Join the wind and go up to. Hi.
How's it going, mate?
Fine. I'm playing tourist. All these glorious trees. Down this pathway of trees. Robert Menzies had his book out called Afternoon Light. And this is the afternoon light of Warracknabeal. This glorious stand of trees down here. Follow up there, you get to the community centre around there. The little neighbourhood house that's up there. Just all sorts of things. We get to wander across here, then we get to walk back along the path along the creek and go down to the areas I haven't been to yet on the way to the Creekside Hotel. Like a place to sit and this big white gum tree. Grey, I suppose. Really white. Yeah, that house has a lovely view here, across here. Look at this creek. And we have a pot of ducks. It's all upstream. Seems like upstream, but I'm not really sure which way this flows. But flows are doing much. We're heading back this way now. This is a day in Warracknabeal. It's been a wonderful day. James Taylor, Carole King songs this morning, lunch, the Warracknabeal show. Now, check a walk around here. Back at the bridge. I'm heading that way. Here. It's a glorious tree that's seen better days, but vines, I'm sure, somewhere for people to look for. But that has come off the trunk there. So, an old corroboree tree. Old identities record the Aborigines conducting ceremonies on this site. The area was known as Coronation Park, then Asquith Park, and now Roma Ross Reserve. Well, Coronation Park, obviously, from the 1952 coronation. Majesty. Up to the edge of the area here, but let's go back in and walk along there. And over there is the bowling club. Come around there. These magnificent trees. I planned to put some Nick Cave on and a couple other bands, but I have not carried no music with me. Nick Cave was born in Warracknabeal. Got to you when he was three, I was told today. Not really come back. But they still claim him, there's a son and there are a couple more ducks cruising the river, the creek. Wonderful trees. Warracknabeal has a lot to commend itself as a place to live and to retire to. I did read an article by Jeff Kennett describing Mildura when he went to open the Vanilla Slice Festival, describing Mildura as having better weather than Surface Paradise. Well, it does get very hot up at Mildura. It gets hot here too, but I think the weather here Warracknabeal is probably better. Certainly houses are a lot cheaper here. There is a lifestyle here that one can blend into. It's much more than Balan, which is freezing cold. And I think people should be moving up to here from Melbourne. Get rid of the mortgage in Melbourne and have a house without a mortgage up here. And live the Australian life that we're meant to be able to live. The banks have taken all everything away from everyone now, so the way around that is to sell up and move to the country. At least 50 towns in Victoria you could move to that provide affordable housing and an ambient, nice lifestyle. Well, what else does Melbourne have? Some 4 o'clock bars and boat opening bars, you might not get those in the country, but does it really matter? There's a hospital here, there's schools here. It's a good spot to be, Warracknabeal. Lovely walks. Little drain that obviously feeds water into the creek. Comes from here. Another magnificent tree. Little ducks. Whatever. What we've got over there looks like another bridge or something. Woodbine Incorporated is here. That might be some social service place. beautiful walkway for me to go across. Let's see if I can go all the way down there. The creek. And no diving, thank you very much. Where did it come from? There are two little ducks. Afternoon light. Traveling along the Yarriambiack Creek. Now the concert we're having this morning is only really once a year for seniors, but it was wonderful. But they have lots of other things here. They have pubs, bands, and the pub during summer, the Creekside, and they've got the Easter Festival, a big parade on Easter Saturday, and battle of the musicians of some description there. Up in the park we're coming up to shortly. And other things. Oh, and about four or five race meetings at the race course. So, there are things going on fairly regularly in the town. And then there are lots of other towns that have festivals and things as well that are around here, all within 40, 50 miles. Horsham has a lot. The property prices here are half what they are in Horsham, so you can do much better here and just commute up to Horsham when you need to go to something at one of their places. Interesting. Big tree here, and I think there's something written about this tree. War service area. This was formerly a market garden to the west and Craig's House and Orange Grove to the east. In 1946, the council subdivided the area and building blocks were given to returning servicemen. The streets are named after famous battles. It's interesting. After the Second World War. Oh, we're getting near the end of our little walk soon, down there. Clearly dropped into the creek some time ago. Nice if they subdivided, gave the land to the turning soldiers. And then would have had to build the houses, but they had Menzies government soon after providing all the money to do all that building. To borrow and do things, build very easily. Long, long bit of tree. It's come off one of those trees. Very nice collection. It goes back into the town, up to Scott Street, and over there is where we're going to eventually end up. First we're going into this park at the end of this walk here. The Lions, Flora, Fauna, Park, barbecues and something else, toilets I think it is. Okay. animals in this park. We shall meet some of them, like that emu up there, and those other birds. Oh, there's even a train for the children. This emu. And his friend, the other emu. Now we have a kangaroo over there. Several kangaroos, I think. And they're all in their own little sanctuary. Peacocks. Lives in plumage. Feathers all the way down there. This one's probably the female one, you see. They don't have all the plumage. More ducks. And more kangaroos. Some of our two emus that are following us along. Dinner time. Is it dinner time for you too as well? Yes. Well, we're not getting too close to you. That's a good boy. Yes, you look peaceful, but you take my finger off if you could. Well, sadly, I had one in my hand. Now we'll have a look at the birds. Here we have some cockatoos. And there's others. There's other ones. Here we have some nice birds. Really get them through the wire. There's one hanging here, another one hanging there. Oh no. There's one. There's some badgies. There we are. Hard to focus on. Some little birds here, but they all seem to be in their little beds. We have some guinea pigs here. Looks like an efficient one. Alright, we're coming to the end of our little walk. We're now going over here to the bridge. Across that bridge. Today is the 10th of October 2019. I think I mentioned it would be the 79th anniversary of my parents' wedding on the 10th of the 10th, 1940. It's the anniversary of the revolution of the double tenth in China on the 10th of the 10th, 1910 or something, or 1920 in China. And it's also the anniversary of great-great-grandmother's or someone's and wedding on the 10th of the 10th, 1880. And 10-10 seems to have some significance. And this is where we're going out. Creek. It's more like a river to me, but it follows a creek. To that Hotel for dinner. It continues on its merry way. That hotel we go. Over there is where we started this morning with the concert in that hall right there. Well, there's a tree, I suppose it is. And you can buy one. Commercial hotel now, then, is the Creekside. Was built on this site by Henry Phillips. James Franklin was the owner from 1903 to 1909. After Franklin's death in 1909, Macomb family conducted the business in the mid-50s. The present structure for most of the part is at least 100 years old. We'll call it the Creekside. And we are going in here. See, everything's so handy around this place. Walk to every day. And this is inside the hotel, and this is where we'll be finishing. Oh, it's night time. It's good night to the Creekside. It's our town hall where we were this morning. The Creekside offers much nicer meals really than down at the Royal Mail. Royal Mail will give you good meals, but and quite a bit cheaper. But if you want boutique meals and things, you come to the Creekside, which has all been done up and is very nice. Of course, eventually the palace will open down the road down there, and then we'll have three pubs running. This other one that's down here that we can see is not open at the moment. Apparently it opens on Easter Saturday. I think that's where it was last time. The next time I must film it. Yeah, here are our bags of wheat and the kelpie looking after the sheep, whatever. Should be down with the sheep. Show you that one in the next corner. It was a very old plough once, that one. And this place sells thousands and thousands of items. It's like the department store at the place, the Wheatland Warehouse. They sell for private vendors there, thousands of them apparently. Well, I'm home now. My two cats have been indoors all day while I've been doing this filming today. This one at the front is Padre. It has the white collar. So of course it's a Padre. And his brother we didn't know about for a long time, whether he's a boy or girl, but he just got called Brother. And now he's Brother. So now I have effectively two religious cats, the Padre and the Brother. And they just love being with me. They adopted me from under the caravan down at Balan, and been with me for many months, and now of course they're registered with the council and everything else, so everything's legal with them. So this is the end of our story for they destroyed this chair, as you can see. It's Brother. These Padre. This Padre, I mean. So, this is the end of our film today. This is Warracknabeal on the 10th of the 10th, 2019.